Hello, and welcome to this lecture on the main characteristics of block flow diagrams, process flow diagrams, and piping and instrumentation diagrams. My name is Marina Miletic. This is an example of a block flow diagram, a BFD for short, for an ethylene oxide production process. Notice this is a very simple, bare bones diagram of an entire process all on one page. There's a lot of detail that's excluded from a diagram like this, but its usefulness lies in its simplicity because you can very quickly determine the most critical units involved in the process. This is an example of a process flow diagram, a PFD for short, again for the same ethylene oxide production process. Notice this diagram includes quite a bit more detail, more equipment, and more streams compared to the block flow diagram. This process flow diagram provides a great deal of information because it includes every piece of equipment and the whole process is shown again all on one page. This is an example of a piping and instrumentation diagram, a PIID for short, of that same ethylene oxide process again. This is just one of the distillation columns in the ethylene oxide process and no other equipment is shown. This is because there's an extraordinary level of detail shown on a piping and instrumentation diagram, where every indicator, control loop, valve, and piping diameter are shown, among other information. Taken together, you can see that the block flow diagrams include the least amount of detail and the piping and instrumentation diagrams the most.